MFA is probably not enough anymore to protect your admin accounts from compromise. There's a lot of new technology out there for ways to simply, for hackers to bypass MFA. So we can't just rely on MFA anymore. We got to do something stronger. And that thing is Microsoft's option for Authentication Strengths. Hey everybody, I'm Doug and this is Doug Does Tech, here to talk to you about Authentication Strengths in Microsoft. We're going to talk about what they are, how they help, and of course, how to implement them. Thanks for coming along. Let's hop into it. So what am I talking about here? Why are we talking about authentication strength and saying MFA isn't maybe the best anymore? It's because this slide here helps illustrate the reason why. It's really talking through, hey, multi-factor, but what are the compromise options that you need to keep in mind of because you have MFA? And so this slide is really helpful for Microsoft about talking about the good, better, best approach to authentication strengths. Here you can see any form of authentication beyond password is pretty good, right? If you at least implement text message, anything, it's still really good, right? But here you can see there's some things that text message is susceptible to, specifically, you know, carrier jacking or real-time phishing are able to be it. Like, for instance, like the story of Twitter's accounts being hacked, where someone went and posed as Jack Dorsey in Verizon and got their SMS moved over. And so we want to move to some stronger options that may be better, right? And that's going to be like your application, like the Authenticator app. It's a lot better option. You're taking away some of the risk by switching to that. But that's still susceptible to phishing attacks, right? So there is some options there. And the best approach is going to be Microsoft's option for passwordless. Specifically, I'm really thinking through FIDO 2 security keys and Windows Hello for Business because they become less susceptible to authentication. Overall, you should consider passwordless anyways because it's good, right? It's a lot better than just text message, but it's still maybe not the best. Overall, there's some good reasons to move to passwordless, right? Elimination of risk, reducing of the need for resets, you know, increased user experience and things like that that you can help in. But I would really love to see you move to FIDO 2 security keys and specifically for your admin accounts. I would love it if your organization bought FIDO 2 security keys and implemented it for all of your admins that need access to your environment. And the reason why is because the FIDO makes it extremely better. So we talked about, you know, if you just use a password, you can come in and, you know, get a lot of different ways you can get compromised by password sprays. And yes, MFA will make it a better experience. You're taking away a lot of those risks out there. But there's been a software package called Evil Jinx that's been introduced that can come in and intercept and do real-time phishing of anybody's authentication. And this works for Google as well as, you know, Microsoft and any other service out there, where it's going to essentially proxy your connection to whatever it is, in this case, Entra. And it's going to capture that token that's being sent back and forth between that authentication process. So you would have MFA'd, but that still has a copy of the token that's in here. And so what we want to do is implement the FIDO 2 security token because FIDO 2 will come in and block that authentication from being allowed to the Evil Jinx proxy server. When you have a FIDO 2 security key, you eliminate that password requirement or that username and password option in there. And then the authentication that's in this token is tied to the original site and it won't release the credentials unless it's that real site. So a proxy connection in there doesn't allow it to be released and can add that additional layer of security. So really cool option there. Now, the question always is, how do you implement it? That's a good note. Why? Well, how do we implement those things? Well, here it is in the Entra portal. What we can do is come into authentication methods, and you'll notice here there's some under authentication methods and then policies, there's a lot of different options for advanced MFA that we can take advantage of. And the one I would love to see you try for your environment is going to be a FIDO 2 security option. In here, we're just going to go in and turn it to on. And if you wanted to scope it down to a select group, you know, like IT test users or, you know, something like that, you could. There's no harm necessarily in scoping it to all users. It doesn't force anybody to use this at this time. It's just simply gonna make the FIDO 2 keys available. So if you had someone that wanted to be safer and you turned this on to all users, you can come in and do that. You do have some options for some advanced stuff like, you know, managing the number of keys that you support and stuff like that. I'm not gonna get into those right now. So simply, if you wanna take advantage of strong authentication and FIDO 2 keys, you're just gonna simply come in here and hit on and save. And that'll enable that for you so you can take advantage of it. The authenticator passwordless option also is in here. And so if you wanted to do that for this, you could enable that as well for your end users. But for me, I really want to have you use FIDO 2 security keys. And that's essentially it for enabling it. Enablement is not the same as enforcement. So that's something you want to think through for your CA policies. How do you force the authentication policies to be used? How do you force FIDO 2 to be required? Well, once we enable it, what we need to do is actually come in and create a new MFA policy for that. So typically what I would do is tell you, hey, you go in here, enable it, and then go register your keys. And how are we going to do that? Well, we're going to come to aka.ms/MFA setup or your My Sign-ins portal. And essentially, you're going to come into here and set up a security key. Once you do, you can walk through the process of registering your security key and enabling it. You, of course, do have to have the physical token available to you to do that. So just go off Amazon, buy one of these. They're $40-$50 a piece, and they're pretty worth it. Right? So you're just going to register the key, and I already have mine registered in here, and so I can then take advantage of it. Now, again, that's not enforcement yet. To do that, we need to come back over to conditional access and do a policy to require it. So to do that, pretty easy option in here. We're going to just go and say strong auth admin account. Right, so we're just going to give it a name. In this case, we're going to scope it to a single test user. In my case, I'm going to use Alex as the requirement there. Target resources, we're going to do all cloud apps to this. And since it's just a simple test, we're just going to scope it to all conditions. And then here's the magic. Instead of just doing the checkbox for authentication, we're going to do authentication strengths and then pick, in this case, phish-resistant MFA. Phish-resistant MFA is all three of those options that Microsoft supports for fast passwordless, right? So it's gonna be, you know, the authenticator app, the FIDO 2, and the security keys. If you wanted to build your own that just required FIDO 2 security keys, you can do that. And just like that, we're set. That will then require the end user to use the authentication methods that we talked about, authentication strength. So let's go test that out here. And we'll go ahead and sign into, in this case, portal.azure. All right, so here we go. Let's go test it. In this case, in here, if you wanted to type in the username, you could. But since I have the FIDO 2 fully set up, I'm going to go ahead and just select the key that I want to use. Use another device. They've updated the dialogues because they have so many new options coming out. It's a little bit of a cumbersome button clicking. But just like that, here is that setup option, and I'm able to go in and authenticate now. I deleted a couple other things out of my environment, for usernames and stuff like that. So it wants me to re-register some of those other options, my secondary backup options, but I'm in. I'm able to use it simply because of that. And so I hope this helps you set up and understand how you can use it. Really cool capability that you can use and take advantage of. And really what I'm recommending for most orgs is to consider using it for your admin accounts, right? So for you, test it out, get your team an FIDO 2 security tokens. And then what I would love to see you do is for all of your global administrators, except for maybe your break glass, right? Come in and require the FIDO 2 security tokens for access to your environment. It's gonna be a fantastic way to help keep your admin safe and keep a hacker from capturing that token in there. So I hope this helps you. Good luck and stay safe out there.